So, for as long as I can remember, both of my parents have had piles of old vinyl records laying around our house, just taking up space. They have no way to play the music that's on the records, but they refuse to get rid of the records. So last year I was inspired to transform one of these obsolete things into a clock that both showed up my love for Billy Joel's music and gave me a much needed clock. You can make one of these clocks in just three basic steps. First, you have to choose the right materials. Next, you have to take an old clock apart. And finally, assemble your new clock. We all have the same boring clocks like that one hanging in our house, so why not be different and make one of these clocks instead? Okay, so the first thing you need to do is to choose the right materials. First and foremost, you're going to need an LP record. LP stands for long play. It's the largest of all the records. You can buy them at yard sales or thrift stores. Goodwill sells them for 50 cents. Then you're going to need a clock movement, which is basically the mechanism of the clock that makes it tick. Again, you can get them at Goodwill, yard sales, or you can buy them in a craft store for like $10, but the hands are not as unique. And other materials, you might need a screwdriver. You might need pliers. You're going to need a AA battery and 3M hanging strips. Okay, so the next thing you need to do is take out the clock movement from an existing clock. So you have to first turn the clock over and look. Does it have screws? This one doesn't, this one does. If it does, your life is so much easier because all you have to do is take the screws out, and that will take off the plastic case on the front. Then all you have to do is take off the hands gently because sometimes they're cheap and they might break. So the second hand, the minute hand, and the hour hand. Some clocks have a ring right here that you just screw off. And then you just have to pop out the movement. Sometimes difficult. Okay, so if it doesn't have screws, it's much more difficult. So I took the plastic off last night because it took me like 20 minutes. So again, you just take off the hands and pop it up. Start putting your new clock together. I'm going to use this Eagles album, and I'm going to use this movement because I think it would look best together. So, take off the hands. These hands are metal, so you have to be careful not to bend them. Okay, so you take the record and you hold it side one facing out, and then you take the movement and you put this little thing and you put it through the back with the battery compartment closest to the floor, and then center it so that the front is gonna be straight. And then this one has a screw, so you have to put that back on. Screw it as tight as you can for right now. Doesn't have to be perfect. And then you're going to put the hands back on, starting with the hour hand. And the minute hand. Then the second hand. And then take pliers and just tighten the ring as far as it'll go. Like that. Okay. Then you're gonna wanna take these hanging strips. I already cut one to size and just stick it on the back. But don't put it near the battery compartment or this wheel to set the time. So just right there is good. And then that's how you hang it on the wall. I'm not going to do that. And then your AA battery, put that in the right way. And it works.
That is awesome.
So, also, you can personalize it if you want. Some people put numbers on them, but I think it looks cool without the numbers. Or I've seen paintings on the outside ring, but I'm not creative enough for that. Okay, so in conclusion, you can make one of these vinyl record clocks in three easy steps. First, you have to choose the right materials. Next, you have to take the movement from an old clock, and then you'll have to assemble your new clock. Not only will you have a unique timepiece to replace the typical clock that hangs on everybody's walls, but you'll also have a clock that costs less, and it'll be a great conversation piece.